Hello friends, my name is Srudhin VS. Welcome to my channel Techmerize. Before I begin, I would like to remind you to please subscribe to my channel and click on that bell icon so that you will get notified whenever I upload a new video. Are you someone who is planning to purchase a laptop? Then you must have searched on an e-commerce site for a laptop that fits in your budget. And the heart of the laptop is the processor in it. And commonly these days we are seeing Intel processors in all the laptops. That's why today we will be discussing about which processor you should choose for your laptop. And also we will be discussing about different generations of processor from Intel lineup. If you are someone who is confused about what processors to choose for your laptop and what all are the numbers that's coming after its model number, you are not alone. I really have no idea what Intel's intentions were, but they have made it pretty difficult for a normal guy to remember all these numbers and what it really means. In low budget laptop segments, apart from few Pentium processors, we are seeing commonly Core i3 as the processors in these laptops. And this is for a casual user who would like to watch movies, listen to some music, do a casual web browsing, and also read some Word documents. And if you look at the specification of this processor, they are coming in mainly two variants. One with 2 cores and hyper-threading enabled. In this case, the CPU will treat it as 4-core processor. And another variant is 4 cores and without hyper-threading enabled. You might be confused about what is hyper-threading. It is an entire topic itself. If you want me to do a video on that hyper-threading, please comment below. I'll be doing a hyper-threading video if you want. As per the naming convention of the processor, we'll be seeing several versions of the Core i3. For example, Core i3-7350K. In this name, we have to notice two things, 7 and the K. The 7 is the generation of the processor it is using, and K will stand for a specific behavior of the processor. And if we were to explain all the possible combination of this alphabet, it will take an entire video to explain. So here, I'll be explaining few commonly seen alphabets and what it actually means. The alphabet K means it enables itself to overclock if the motherboard allows it to. And there is another alphabet U, which means ultra low power, which means it is very power efficient. And there is another alphabet X, which is only seen in Core i9, which indicates very high-end processor. Coming back to Core i3. You can play some low-end graphics games in this Core i3, but if you want to perform more, it will definitely disappoint you. But at this price segment, you can't complain about it. So if your requirement is a bit more and you are someone who would like to do some coding with Photoshop editing and mid-level gaming, you should consider Core i5. In Core i5, mainly 3 variants is there. The 6-core variant with hyper-threading not enabled, and there is a 4-core variant with hyper-threading enabled. And there is a 2-core variant with hyper-threading enabled, which is mainly seen in ultrabooks and mobile platforms. In Core i5 compared to Core i3, you can see more cache and also higher clock speeds, which will be more expensive compared to the i3 variant in the same generation. Talking about expensive, we have next level processor, i7. If you are someone who would like to do some video editing or rendering or play some high-end games and crazy resource-consuming softwares, then you should consider Core i7. In this processor, mainly 3 variants are present, 2-core, 4-core and 6-core variant. In all the variants, hyper-threading is enabled. And in the highest variant for i7, we have 12 MB of cache, which is higher than Core i5 counterpart, and which will also perform more powerful and faster than Core i5. If you want to go even higher, Intel have one more option, Core i9, in which we have 10, 12, 14, 16 and 18 core variants. In all the variants, we have hyper-threading enabled. For a normal user, this is sky in terms of performance and price. So now we know what is i3, i5 and i7 and which processor to choose for your laptop. Now let's walk into the different generation of these processors. With each new generation of these processors, they are improving the technology with which they are developing these processors. The latest generation, as of now, it is 8th gen, is developed using a 14-nanometer technology, which will be very power efficient and also very powerful in overall perspective. There is one main point and takeaway from this video. We are saying this after seeing several benchmark scores and after several comparison videos. This have to be kept in mind when you are going to purchase a laptop. The 8th gen processor of i5 may perform better than the 7th gen processor of i7. Similarly, the 8th gen processor of Core i3 may perform better than the 7th gen processor of Core i5. That's it for today. Thank you for watching. If you find this video informative, please like and subscribe to my channel. And don't forget to click on that bell icon so you'll get notified whenever I upload a new video. Goodbye. See you on the next video. Adios.